Sadly, research has shown that in general, there's probably a ratio of like 5 negative thoughts to a positive thought. So that suggests that from an evolutionary perspective, that there must be some reason why we have a negative bias, right? To be prepared for a threat, perceived or imaginary, to be ready to respond effectively to perceived threat. So there's a whole area recently, past 20 plus years, about not just genetics, but epigenetics, which is that certain genes in our chromosomes can be turned on or off, or are more as a function of not only what our parents went through in their lifetime, but even grandparents and before. So concrete example, there's research showing that when there was a famine, say 800 years ago in Sweden, there were genes that were turned on or off in the adults who were living at that time, that then gets expressed, transmitted from their offspring to their offspring, which means that we carry a genetic predisposition from what other people experienced in our genetic lineage back in time, which is a fascinating way of thinking about the transmission of information and experience across generations. So there's something about the negative bias that we humans have that may serve a function in some contexts, obviously not all contexts, but to drive our attention, our readiness to respond, to notice things that might be threatening physically or mentally or socially to ourselves. So that's one reason why we have more negative thoughts. And then maybe negative thoughts are more sticky because they might generate more arousal, right? There are lots of positive emotions that might have high arousal or energy, but also some that are low. But negative emotions generally drive the brain quite hard. And that maybe gives us a kind of readiness to take action. However, if we're living in situations where there's not a lot of threat, then those negative thoughts or negative biases, negative filters, can actually undermine our well-being. So that means we have to become more skillful in learning our specific contour of negative thoughts and emotions and how to create a little bit of space from them, a buffer, so to speak. For example, I'm thinking jealousy, right? Social comparison, it's a huge problem, right? Especially in modern societies where we see others that have more stuff or more fame or more position. So jealousy can be very toxic and it can be really undermining to our own well-being. So one way to work with that would be to bring a mind of equanimity or bring a mind of rejoicing that others have what they have and that they have what they need, and bringing a sense of contentment to oneself. And knowing that having more doesn't necessarily mean being more happy. That because somebody else has more material or doesn't mean that for me to be well, I need the same amount of physical material. So that's one way to work with the mind, which is kind of a reappraisal, but it's also bringing the contemplative quality of equanimity, that be it... when I do social comparison in relation to friend, enemy, stranger, etc., that I equalize my view towards all.